Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm Andrea, and today I have my second update for the Friends Project Pan. This is a project that was created by Amy from Curly Loves Beauty and Books. I will, of course, have her channel linked down below. And it's all about the TV show Friends. There are 15 prompts plus one bonus prompt, and it is only a 6-month project, so it started February 17th, and it will run until August 17th. I decided to just go ahead and roll all of the prompts in at once just so I could make sure that I actually got through them all. And I don't have any prompts completed yet, but I do have some progress on most things, so we'll get right into it. First, for Monica, your cleanest product, I had found a kit from Andalou Naturals at Marshall's, and it was their vitamin C line, I think, and it was their orange line, and it had 5 little minis in it. I have already finished the cleanser. I finished that for the first update. For this update, I have the toner done. This little guy got me 33 uses. I actually was working on a full size of this in a spray bottle, so once that was done, I just poured this into the spray bottle and then used it until it was gone because I like the mister. Instead of pouring toner into my hands and then like doing that whole thing. So this is gone. There's 3 products left. There's a pumpkin honey mask, which I have only used once total. I have not used it in the past month. And then there's 2 creams. There's the renewal cream, which is the day cream, and then there's this night cream. Now I started using this. I used this 6 times, and then I was thinking, I'm going on vacation this summer. And I don't have any travel size moisturizers for day or night. So instead of using these up now when I'm already working on other stuff, I'm going to save these, this and then the day cream, for when I go on vacation. I'm going to bring them with me, and then I probably won't finish them up then, but I will have them. They're small enough that I will have them finished for the finale. So I'm not going to be using this or the day cream until July, probably. So I'm not going to show you them again until I actually use them. That mask, hopefully I'll finish it up soonish, but I haven't used it once in the past month, so who knows? Next, for Rachel, a high maintenance product, and I'm wearing it today, and let me tell you, I don't know. This is from Kristen Lee Cosmetics. These are loose, like kind of multi-chrome-ish flakies. This is in the shade Trip. I have a 15-use goal on this. I've used it 3 times so far. Okay, so I have them on. It isn't creasing. It's just I have my glitter glue just in this portion, but of course I have hooded eyes, so when I open my eyes, some of the flakes transferred up, but it's not a crease. It's just I didn't put any there. They've just transferred up there because these things are insane. Anyway, I don't know how well you can see. I think I got most of it, but basically my entire face was covered in flakes. No matter what I do. I don't know if you can also see, my chest is covered in flakes. My table where I do my makeup at is covered in flakes. So this is very high maintenance, and I'm very annoyed, honestly. It's beautiful, but it is such a pain in the butt to work with. So I still have 12 uses to go on that one. Next, for Pheobe, your most vivid colored product or packaging. I brought in my Ace Beauté Slice of Paradise palette because it's a very bright rainbow palette. I have a 3-use goal on each shade. And so far I've worn these 2 yellows, well, this yellow and this more like marigold orangey shade once. I actually have both of those on today. And then I've worn this pink and purple once, this blue shade macaw, which is hard to see it, but it also blended in with the yellows and made it a little green, but I have that on my outer corner. And then I've used this blue once and this green once, so still got a ways to go on this one, but so far it's a nice palette. I'm liking it. Then for Ross, an ancient or discontinued product in your collection, I brought in my Physician's Formula Healthy Foundation because this has been discontinued for quite a long time. I have a 20-use goal in it. I've used it 7 times. I'm using it today. It's nice, but it is not the right shade for me. I have LC1. I don't know why I have and had and continue to have such a hard time figuring out what exactly my shade is. But for a while there, I was going way too light. This is, I don't think it's really noticeable. I think I blended it okay down my neck. Plus, you know, your neck is usually always paler. But it's a little light. So, yeah, I'm going to need to hurry up and get my 20 uses done on this before I really get a tan, because then I'm just going to look ridiculous. But 7 out of 20 on that. Chandler, a product with a funny name. I have 6 polishes that I think have funny names. I have not used any of those over the past month. I have used one previously, so I've got 5 left. Joey, a product with a food name, scent, or packaging. Again, I have 6 polishes for Joey because, you know, Chandler and Joey go together. So I wanted to... Okay, let's not pretend that I actually planned it. It was just... That's my reasoning for why I did what I did. But I have used 2 polishes that I brought in for Joey. The first, and I think I have pictures, so if I do, I will post them or, like, insert them. The first is from Garden Path Lacquers. This is the shade A Rat with a Whisk and a Dream. It's based off the movie Ratatouille. And it is gorgeous. It looks in the bottle. I don't know how well you can see the shifts, but it is like a greeny gold. And then it flips to this beautiful pink, and it's got flakies and it's got holographic goodness in it. And this was so pretty. I really, really loved it. So that's 1 polish gone for Joey. And then the next polish I wore for Joey was my Cleona Cosmetics Dragontini. I think I did this for my Easter mani because, I mean, it's just the perfect Easter / spring color. It is so beautiful. It's a corally orange that flips pink, and then it's got this green shimmer running through it. It is so pretty. I'm so glad I picked this up. So I used that one. So that is 2 out of the 6 polishes for Joey. I have 4 left. Then for Ursula, a product you have 2 of. I have 2 of these Too Faced Hangover RX Pillow Bombs specifically in the scent, shade, whatever, Mango Kiss. I've only got 12 uses on this. I haven't been focusing on it. And these are, it's kind of hard to see with the windowing. I mean, I'm about down here, but these are not like full by any means when you get them. So that looks like I used a lot for 12 uses, but it really wasn't a lot. I don't know if I said, my goal is to finish that. We'll see. For Gunther, I actually have 2 products because I picked one and then I forgot I had this other one. And I'm like, I'll just bring both of them in. So the first I should tell you the prompt. That might help. Coffee scented or coffee in the product name. So the first item that I originally picked was this Floral Street sample of Ylang Ylang Espresso. Which, as you can see, focus. I've used 4 times and I'm down to here, so let's just call it a third. I've used a third. And then when I was looking for a product for a different prompt, I found this, because I forgot I had it. This is the Frank Body Cacao Coffee Scrub. And it's, where does it say? On the back it says, contents smell like cake, and boys may fight over you like you're the last slice. Now, I have not had anybody fighting over me, but I have used this 2 times, and it smells really good. I smell more chocolate than coffee, but that's okay. So, the one thing is, I don't know that I really do like these. I don't know if you can hear that bird. Somebody is out there having a good time, I guess. I don't know. I really like this, but I guess we'll see how many uses I end up getting out of it, because I do use this on my entire body, and I kind of want to, like, feel like it's actually doing something, so I use a pretty generous amount. So I don't know. These are a little bit on the pricier side. I want to say it's like $18 for something like this. I'm not quite positive, but it's around that price point. But they do smell really good. Although your shower will look like you murdered a coffee bean in it. Several coffee beans. Many, many, many coffee beans. This stuff gets everywhere, but it smells really good. And it does leave my skin feeling nice and like buffed and smooth and soft. Next for Janice, an annoying product to use, and I picked my, what is going on out there? My Stila Kitten Karma Glitter and Glow. These are a pain in the butt to use because they dry up so fast. No, actually, this is still, from whenever I used it last, it's still kind of hydrated. It's pretty sheer though. Did I say this is a shade Kitten Karma? I don't know. Anyway, I mean, it's a pretty shade. It's just these things dry up so fast and they're annoying to rehydrate all the time. So my goal is 20 uses on that and I've got 3. Very pretty though. Like I said, it does have a base color, but it is kind of sheer and it is mostly glittery. So it's definitely more of a topper than an actual shadow. You can kind of call a one and done sort of thing, but I digress. Then for Mr. Treager, a product that fixes your look, I picked my LYS Triple Fix Full Coverage Brightening Concealer. And my goal is to finish it. I've got 24 uses on it. I really like this concealer a lot, actually. I cannot tell where I'm at in this product with the 24 uses. There's no windowing at all. And I mean, I can't see in the bottle. So we'll see. This is the shade LN6. And I think for winter, it's probably like the teeniest little bit too dark for me for winter time. But as I move through summer, it should probably turn out to be a pretty good shade. I'm sure I swatched it before, but I'll swatch it again just because. Why not? So this is what it is. So, yeah, but when I'm at my fairest, this is probably too dark for wintertime, but I think it'll be a really good summer concealer shade, and I've been enjoying it a lot. So, 24 uses on that. No idea if I will finish it, if it's possible to finish it before the end of the project, but I'm going to try. Then for Carol, a woman-owned brand, I decided to bring in my lipstick from Give, which is Gwen Stefani's brand. This is the shade Original Recipe. Here's what it is. It's also what's on my lips. I have a 20-use goal on this, and I've used it 3 times so far, so still I gotta use a little bit more. So far, I think it's a really nice lipstick. It is a matte formula, but like I'm wearing it today over my lip balm, so it's a little more slippery, and it's got a little more probably shine than it would on its own, but so far it's nice. Then for Marcel, a product with animal pattern, packaging, or name, I have my Menagerie Whale Song palette. Again, I have a goal to use each shade 3 times. Whoops. And so far, I don't have more than 1 use on any shade, and there are 3 shades I have not used. So I have not used these 2 or this one yet, but I have used all the rest 1 time. Today I have Plankton on. It looks really baby poopy in the pan. I don't know how well you're going to be able to see it. I just have that on my lid as a matte shade, and it's a little more sagey, at least on my skin tone, than, like, I thought it was going to be a lot more yellow than it really is. But I don't know. Like, look at it in the pan and then look at it on my finger. I'm not complaining about it. It's still baby poopy. Don't get me wrong. It's still a baby poopy shade. But it doesn't have quite as much yellow in it as it looks in the pan. So anyway, I'm wearing that shade today. Then for Frank Jr., a product that gets better as you use it. I picked a mascara because I don't know. I have this Glamour Dolls mascara. My goal is obviously to finish it. I've I misspoke in my last video. I said I was going to keep this until June because I somehow forgot that the month of May existed. I'm keeping this in until May. That will be the 3-month mark, and I don't like this enough to try to squeeze every last like little bit out of it. It's not that great. Kind of defeats the purpose of this, this prompt, because I don't think this is getting better as I use it, but whatever. So I've got 42 uses on this because I use this mascara every time I do my makeup. So, and at the next update, it will be an empty. Then for Mr. Heckles, a product with pan, I picked my Fenty Beauty Peach Face Cream Blush because I had a very decent amount of pan in it already. And I have a 20-use goal. I've used it 8 times. I have it on today. I do have like a powder blush on top of it, but I think you can still see this peeking through a little bit. I love this blush and this shade so much. I'm sad that this was just a limited edition like holiday shade, but not that I will finish this anytime soon. I do have a Milani cream blush that I found at TJ Maxx because I don't believe that they carry that shade anymore either. That I haven't swatched it. I haven't opened it because I don't want to open it yet when I still have this, but they look like pretty much spot on shade dupes. I can't speak to the formula, obviously, on the Milani one because I haven't opened it, but at least when this is gone, I'll have a similar color cream blush to tide me over. But I really love this, so I've still got 12 more uses to go on this one. Then for Emily, a product you tend to lose. I tend to lose my hand creams. I also kind of tend to forget about them. So I have this hand cream from the Body Shop. It's just a little baby in coconut. My goal is to finish it, and I've used it 8 times since the beginning of the project. 8 times in 2 months. So yeah. Then finally, the bonus prompt is Miss Chanandler Bong, a product from a subscription. And this is a bonus prompt because Amy knows not everybody gets or has gotten subscription boxes in the past. So if you've got subscription box stuff, then you can do this. If you don't, then you can just skip it. So I decided to go with one of my Skylar Rollerballs because I get this through their Scent Club subscription box. This is in the scent Citrus Grove. I thought that'd be a nice like springy slash summery scent. I don't know why I'm opening it up to smell it because I am wearing it today, but it's citrusy, but a little got like the tiniest bit of spice, something else to it. I really like it. I have a 20-use goal and I've used it 6 times. So that is it for my friend's project pan update for next month. Definitely the mascara, because like I said, I'm only using this for 3 months, and next month will be the 3rd month, or next update will have been the end of the 3rd month. You know what I'm saying. That will be done, but I don't think anything else is going to be done. Yeah, nothing else is going to be done. This is going to be a project where if I hit my goals, it's all, like, everything is going to be done at the end. That's okay, though. So that is it for me for today. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you're staying safe and sane and healthy, having a wonderful day or night wherever you are. And I will talk to you in the next one. Bye!